So we need to repeat few things when it comes to the understanding, basic understanding of students for application of this for BRM understanding, right? So is the screen visible to you all? Yes, no?
Yes, sir, visible.
What can you see now?
Data collection methods, method of
data collection methods you can see. And fine, I don't know why I'm not able to see that. Okay, so great. You all know what kind of data we use in the research, right? In BRM subject, I think this has been told and discussed many times that you need data. When you talk about research, when you are talking about finding out new information, कैसे हवा से उठा में हवा में से उठा के तो हम इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं पकड़ ढूंढ सकते, राइट? To find out any kind of information for decision making, we will need data. And I'm just discussing points as per the second chapter of your university syllabus, right? So even though if it is repetition, I think you all know what are the types of data and what are all the sources of those types of data, right? So when you talk about data collection, what are the methods of data collection, right? You may have two types of data, that is primary data and secondary data. You know what are the methods by which you can collect primary data. Given to the right hand side of this particular slide, you can check out primary data sources, right? Can you tell me at least one example by which you can collect data? How can you collect data with the help of observation, and where did you do that? Anyone?
Sir,
yes.
In experiments, if we are doing some experiments, we can observe the outcomes.
Mm-hmm. In experimental research, like when you are into whenever you are into laboratories, right? Chemical laboratories, or whenever you are doing clinical research, experimental research, then you observe it and you record the observations. What do you record in the laboratories? You record various readings, various changes into the color and shape of color, density and volatility of the various fluids. हमने किया था ना 11 12th में, हमने जो रिसर्च कर रहे थे, एक क्या करते थे हम, दो तीन लिक्विड एक दूसरे के साथ मिला दो, देखो कलर चेंज हो रहा है क्या, अगर पेल येलो हो रहा है तो इसका मतलब अमोनिया इज प्रेजेंट इन टू दैट, इधर ही सो पर्पल हो रहा है तो मैग्नीशियम है उसमें. स्मॉल स्मॉल एक्सपेरिमेंट्स वी यूज्ड टू डू एंड वी यूज्ड टू रिकॉर्ड आवर ऑब्जर्वेशंस देयर इन दोस काइंड ऑफ रिसर्चर. सो व्हेनेवर यू आर इनटू एक्सपेरिमेंटल स्टडी, व्हाट डू? You take two groups. One group is called as control group, the other group is called as the test groups, right? Test group ke upar, experimental group ke upar aap kuch treatment karoge, particular XYZ kind of treatment you will do on that group. For example, if you wanted to understand what are the impacts of training on employee behavior, right? So aisa nahi ki aap sabko training doge aur aap you will try to compare what is the impact. By that way, you will not understand what is the impact of training on employee performance and behavior in the organization. For that, what you need to do? You need to conduct an experiment in which you will have one group which is control group, it means it has been not given a training, and one group which is experimental group, to which you will give some treatment of training. You will ask them to go through various kind of training, so that will become your control that will become your experimental group, and the group which has been not treated is your control group. In such kind of groups, you will observe what are the changes happened into the experimental group after giving the training. So observations will be noted, right? Not necessarily you will go and do their survey, not necessarily you will create a questionnaire and you will ask the questions to those employees. You will give them a training, you will put them on the job, and you will observe what are the changes happen in their daily routine jobs, and you will compare those observations with the control group, with the non-treated group. By that way, you will get to know that how you can use the observational studies, observational data collection into the research studies, right? So primary survey hai, primary source hai data, because researcher himself is observing what are the kind of changes and what kind of observations you may have in such kind of experimental group and control group. You may check out whether the efficiency in terms of number of units produced by that employee has been increased or no. You may check the punctuality of the employee has been increased in comparison with the control group, that is non-treated group, right? So treated group and non-treated group, which is called as treated will be called as experimental, non-treated will be called as control group. So you will compare the performance of employees from both the groups and you will observe and you will note down those observations based on which you will come out with the findings of your research by observation data collection methods. Can it be done? Kya lagta hai? Is it possible? Is it sensible whatever I am saying? Is it? Yes. And where else can you use such kind of observational data collection methods in order to identify consumers purchase pattern, consumers purchase behavior, consumers purchase intentions? Can you stand in front of the shelves put into the DMart and note down the observations of consumers? कोई बुड्ढा इंसान आता है तो कैसे इस वो प्रोडक्ट को ट्रीट करता है, कैसे देखता है? कोई यंग आता है तो कैसे देखता है उस प्रोडक्ट को? विदाउट आस्किंग देम, इट मीन्स विदाउट आस्किंग देम, यू आर कलेक्टिंग डेटा बाय योर ओन अंडरस्टैंडिंग इन टर्म्स ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशंस एंड यू आर नोटिंग इट डाउन. सो इट कैन बी डन इन मोस्ट इन मेनी काइंड ऑफ रिसर्चर्स वेर एवर यू विल फील दैट यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू गिव लिबर्टी टू द रिस्पॉन्डेंट्स टू गिव अ डायरेक्ट रिस्पॉन्सेस टू योर सर्वे. देर यू कैन यूज दिस observation method. You are standing in front in a mall, in front of the in front of the shelves in the stores, and you are observing how people are behaving, how much time they are keeping that product in hand and putting it down, right? Agar aap DMart mein khade ho, suppose koi aaya, usne dekha shelves pe kaun sa product hai, uthaya, dekha, turant rakh diya, iska matlab kya hai? What does it mean?
कुछ ना कुछ उसको अच्छा नहीं लगा होगा.
प्रोडक्ट इज नॉट कैची. यस, दैट प्रोडक्ट इज नॉट कैचिंग द फर्स्ट साइट ऑफ द कस्टमर्स, राइट? देखते से ही वो हाथ में रख के रख दे रहा है. मतलब द टाइम दे आर होल्डिंग दैट प्रोडक्ट और वॉचिंग दैट प्रोडक्ट और लुकिंग टुवर्ड्स दैट प्रोडक्ट इज वेरी लेस. सो दिस इज ऑब्जर्वेशन. सो वॉट यू नीड टू डू, यू मे नीड टू इम्प्रूव ऑन द कलर कॉम्बिनेशन, पैकेजिंग, राइट? एम आई ऑडिबल?
Yes, sir, yes.
Okay, so I am connected to my mobile device then. Light, electricity has gone now. Okay, fine. So, such kind of observations you can do. Rest all the things I am not going to focus a lot, like interviews and questionnaire and all. So, you all know that when you talk about the qualitative research, when you talk about the qualitative research, where you are looking out the information from expert, like industry experts or subject matter experts, what you are going to do? You will, can you, like, for example, let's take an example of, let's suppose you want to study what will be the future scope of journalism in India. What will be the future scope for journalism in India, right? In Sir, Satya, what is the strength?
So now it's 39.
Okay, fine. Okay, 39. So it was like when you talk about the future scope of journalism in India, can you do any survey for that? Do you have any historical data which can predict the future of journalism in India? So this is a qualitative matter, right? This is a matter which can be only studied with the help of qualitative information, maybe in terms of understanding of that field, maybe in terms of looking after the developments happening into that field, looking after the availability of the expert and literate people, those who are helping to develop that field. यहाँ पे आप survey नहीं कर सकते हो, कोई qualitative data नहीं है, you cannot use any technique, regression technique. हाँ, but if you want to understand the market size of journalism industry or media industry or news industry, then you can use the regression techniques and statistical techniques. But just in terms of looking out the perspective towards the future of journalism in India, what you need to do? You need to go and talk to the topmost people in the industry. You need to go and talk to the well and reputed journalists, those who are going to tell you about their interpretations of futures in that industry, future in that industry, because they are going through the existing scenario, they are going through the existing industry, they know the industry in and out. they can predict what is going to happen. They can predict what is going to happen based on the existing scenario. Existing scenario kya ho sakte hain? Culture, the scope, the ability of people, literacy of the people in journalism. All those things will affect the future of journalism industry. And if you really want to study the future, or if you really want to I'm sorry guys, I got disconnected as usual. This is frustrating situation, but fine. So I was talking to you about the future of journalism industry in India. We cannot predict it with the help of existing records or historical records. Actually, we cannot predict it by the discussions with expert people also. But what we are going to do, we are going to try out, we are going to give out the max. दोबारा इन्वर्ट किया है मतलब?
अरे कुछ बच्चों में इन्वर्ट करने के बाद ब्रेक ऑफ तो नहीं आ रहा है
तो उसका हो जाएगा क्या अभी
नहीं
पूछता हूँ सर क्लास के बाद पूछता हूँ Okay, so am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
I cannot see the list of participants even. I don't know what is happening. Am I again?
Yes, sir. You're audible, sir.
I am again losing the connection. 46 people are there. Okay, fine. So what I was talking to you about, when we want to discuss about some qualitative aspect of any particular issue, what we can do is that we can use the expert opinion method, where we will go and talk to the people. Those who knows such kind of issues in and out, right? So expert opinion methods are being used in terms of collecting data with the help of interviews, right? You are going to talk, you are going and talking to the people, those who deserve to give answer, those who are eligible to answer your question, your query, to whom you can trust that they would be giving you a suitable information in order to resolve your issue. So you may talk about industry issues, you may talk about practical issues. For example, you have started your own business in automobile manufacturing, some components of automobile manufacturing, and you don't know now what kind of business opportunities you have, what kind of business scope you have. You wanted to expand, you don't know, in the sense you want to know something more about that. राइट किसी को पता नहीं तो बिजनेस शुरू नहीं करेगा आप बोले पता नहीं तो मैंने शुरू कैसे किया सो आपने अपना स्टडी कर लिया बट यू एंड यू हैव एस्टेब्लिश्ड योर ओन बिजनेस आल्सो नाउ यू वांट टू नो द इंडस्ट्री यू वांट टू अंडरस्टैंड द कल्चर सिनेरियो स्कोप यू वांट टू डेवलप योर ओन इंडस्ट्री रिलेशंस व्हाट कैन यू डू इन दैट केस यू कैन गो टू द एक्सपर्ट ऑफ दैट इंडस्ट्री एंड टॉक टू देम इन टर्म्स ऑफ टेकिंग देयर इंटरव्यूज राइट सच इंटरव्यूज कैन बी ऑफ टू वेज लाइक In such interviews, you will ask, you may have a structured questionnaire. Everywhere you are using the similar kind of questions, sequence of the questions will be similar, right? Though you are getting the different answers, but you may talk to the multiple people in that industry and you will use the similar sequence with the similar questions, same questions rahega. That is called as the structured interview questionnaire. That is called as the structured interviews, right? So you may have a structured or unstructured interview. That is, you will be going and talking casually in order to understand, giving them a liberty to speak whatever they want to tell you. So that can be a kind of interviewing where you are again collecting qualitative data. So questionnaire you all know, right? Questionnaire you all know. Interview के लिए भी questionnaire हो सकता है, structured unstructured दो हो सकता है. Questionnaire भी हो सकते हैं. There are two types of questionnaire: structured questionnaire, unstructured questionnaire, open-ended questionnaire, structured, closed-ended questionnaire. So you all have discussed about what do you mean by open-ended and closed-ended questionnaire, right?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
You have not shared the screen.
I have not shared the screen. क्या करो यार मेरा thank you for reminding but I have lost my tempo also मतलब I don't know why. This interruptions creates too many problems. I am not able to see from where I can share the screen now. पता नहीं कहाँ. Okay हाँ दिख रहा है. Okay so I was talking about this particular thing right. You have structured unstructured questionnaire for the interviews as we have discussed, and you have open-ended, closed-ended questionnaires for open-ended, closed-ended questionnaires for survey also, right? So yeah, आप लोगों ने discuss किया हुआ है. You know the things. You can ask me any query if there is in your mind. You can ask me the questions. No doubt about that. And then when we talk about the secondary sources of information that you know from where you can go get the secondary data. Right, I believe everybody is clear about what is primary data and secondary data. अगर clear नहीं भी होना इस time पे तो कोई मतलब ही नहीं MBA करने का, right? जिसको पता नहीं है what is primary data and secondary data, do not do MBA. You don't deserve to do MBA. Simple word में, right? And what are the sources? वो भी that also you must have been discussed. क्योंकि मैंने बहुत बार discuss किया है individually, individual सभी divisions में. And another point is that BRM में भी first semester में पढ़ाया गया है and you have passed that subject in university examination. So expected you all know all this concept. Any doubt on this screen you can ask me. So secondary data is which is already published information. You need to collect both kind of data. You need to adopt any kind of the methods of collection of data for your market research from the techniques given on the screen. इसमें से कोई भी एक ऑप्शन हो सकता है जिससे आप मार्केटिंग रिसर्च का डेटा कलेक्ट कर सकते हो एंड यू नीड टू यूज दिस टेक्निक्स एटलीस्ट यू नीड टू यूज दिस टेक्निक्स नॉट एटलीस्ट बट मेनी टाइम्स इन योर लाइफ राइट. अगर आप मार्केटिंग रिसर्च में जाते हो या फिर इवन दो इफ यू डोंट गेट मार्केटिंग रिसर्च यू विल वर्क इन अ मार्केटिंग डिपार्टमेंट एंड देयर यू विल इंटरप्रिटिंग सो मेनी रिसर्चर्स फ्रिक्वेंटली इन योर लाइफ. कितने भी रिसर्च रिपोर्ट आपने आपके पास आएंगे इंटरप्रेट करने के लिए बिकॉज यू वेन एवर यू वर्किंग एज अ मैनेजर टॉप मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द कंपनी विल ऑलवेज कीप गिविंग यू वेरियस रिपोर्ट्स. लुक एट दिस इज द रिपोर्ट पब्लिश बाय दैट कंपनी दिस इज द रिपोर्ट पब्लिश बाय दिस एसोसिएशन दिस यूनियन दिस मिनिस्ट्री दिस डिपार्टमेंट एंड यू नीड टू इंटरप्रेट दोज रिपोर्ट्स वेरी फ्रिक्वेंटली इन यूर लाइफ वेन यू आर इन वेन यू विल बी वर्किंग इन अ कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड राइट. इकोनॉमिक टाइम्स का रिपोर्ट आएगा टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया का रिपोर्ट आएगा इसका सर्वे आएगा उस मिनिस्ट्री का आएगा इस गवर्नमेंट का आएगा वो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट का आएगा. देर आर सो मेनी डिपार्टमेंट्स विच क्रिएट्स रिपोर्ट्स एंड रिसर्च टू गाइड द इंडस्ट्री टू गाइड द एग्जिस्टिंग बॉडी ऑफ नॉलेज राइट टू इम्प्रूव द एग्जिस्टिंग बॉडी ऑफ नॉलेज. सो यू विल बी द पर्सन दो यू वर्क इन अ सेल्स दो यू वर्क इन अ मार्केटिंग दो यू वर्क इन एनी काइंड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट इन द मार्केटिंग फील्ड you will have to face so many reports. आपने खुद में भी देखा होगा हर रोज अगर आप न्यूज देखते हो या फिर न्यूज पढ़ते हो या फिर इफ यू गो थ्रू द इकोनॉमिक टाइम्स पेपर और इंडिया टूडे और बिजनेस एनी बिजनेस न्यूज पेपर फॉर दैट मैटर यू विल अंडरस्टैंड दे न्यूज पेपर आर्टिकल्स ऑलवेज कोट डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ फिगर्स परसेंटेज अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिपोर्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू द नेल्सन रिपोर्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू द डिलॉयट रिपोर्ट. आई एम नॉट टेकिंग द नेम्स ऑफ इंटरनेशनल बॉडीज. आई थिंक I am very fortunate if you know about the national that is Indian bodies only. If you have heard about the Nielsen report. Nielsen report is what? It's a market research company. Talks about various kind of industries in India about their market share, market segment, future growth, CAGR, all those things it keeps talking about. If you know about Deloitte, Deloitte is the financial consulting company which talks about the financial performance analysis of most of the manufacturing companies and every another day they send their reports to the business newspapers like Economic Times and all, and those reports get published in paper and you should be the person who understand those reports right. So aapko lagega marketing department mein jaake hum kaha marketing research har roz uthke karne wale. Understand, you are not going to do marketing research. You need to do sales, you need to do branding, campaigning, advertisement, creativity and all. But along with that, you need to work a lot in order to understand what is the methodology of that particular report which has been reached to you. You need to understand the methodology, suitability अगर मेथोडोलॉजी पता चलेगा तब पता चलेगा ना आपको ये रिसर्च रिपोर्ट मुझे सुटेबल है या नहीं है. शुड आई बिलीव ऑन दैट रिपोर्ट, इज इट रियली कंसर्न ऑफ माई बिजनेस. नहीं तो हर एक रिपोर्ट आएगा तो उसको आप सीरियस लेके बैठोगे, अरे नहीं ये तो पढ़ना ही चाहिए, और पता चले आपके काम का ही नहीं है. मे बी फॉर दैट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज द मेथोडोलॉजी इन टर्म्स ऑफ कलेक्टिंग सैंपल, इन टर्म्स ऑफ कलेक्टिंग डेटा यूज इन दैट पर्टिकुलर रिपोर्ट. ये सब चीजें आपको समझ के रखनी है, राइट. सो दैट पर्टिकुलर वे यू विल नीड दिस मार्केट रिसर्च फॉर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. तो प्राइमरी डेटा, सेकेंडरी डेटा, कौन सा मेथोडोलॉजी क्या है, ये सब आप लोगों को पता होना चाहिए. नहीं है तो सीख लेना, राइट. एनी डाउट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्लाइड? एनी डाउट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्लाइड?
नो सर.
आई विल प्रोसीड विद द नेक्स्ट वन एंड लेट्स टॉक अबाउट डेटा कलेक्शन टूल्स. दिस इज अगेन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड क्वांटिटेटिव एंड क्वालिटेटिव टूल्स. इन टर्म्स ऑफ क्वांटिटेटिव टूल्स यू हैव द रिकॉर्ड्स पब्लिश्ड ऑन द वेबसाइट्स. यू मे गो फॉर द फेस टू फेस इंटरेक्शंस थ्रू द क्वेश्चनर. देयर यू विल कलेक्ट द survey information in terms of qualitative variable and you will convert it into a quantitative variable by assigning few scaling techniques on those numbers. So ab bolega re mai face to face kisi ko milta hu questionnaire bhar ke leta hu to how it data becomes the quantitative. See, when you collect data, the scaling of data is used to convert qualitative data into quantitative. Aap agar kisi ko puchte ho how satisfied you are about the product and he says that like not at all or least satisfied or not dissatisfied, highly dissatisfied to strongly satisfied or highly satisfied or strongly agree, suppose that kind of scale. So it's the scaling of qualitative information about of that customers on some numbers. So you are using scales there to convert qualitative information into quantitative. So face to face discussions, phone, mail, and like central location intercepts, this is kind of statistical method, right? Statistical method by which you calculate mean, mode, median, average. That these are the measures of central tendency, right? So you will collect qualitative information, quantitative information through such techniques. And like in qualitative, you know, online forums, forms, web surveys, groups, and interviews and all. So these are the methods of data collection. So next point is about population identification or population definition, right? You know, when this population picture will be in front of you, when this population word will come in picture, आपको क्या लगता है? In all kind of surveys or sorry, in all kind of researchers, you need to do population, you need to define population or only surveys. I mean, is it like in every kind of research we think we need to think about population and sample size? Is it like that?
So whenever the research is out and out secondary research, then we don't need. But if it's primary research, then we definitely need.
Yes, and in primary research also, you need not to define the population of your research in all the types of research. It is only into a descriptive research which is related to survey, right? Only a descriptive research related to survey. If you talk about observational research, then probably you may need not to think about the population, because you may observe the people as per your convenience. You may observe 10 people or 100 people, doesn't matter, right? Because observation of people is a very subjective issue. Behavior of the people towards your product through observation method is a very subjective. It can change very naturally, and so this kind of researchers also not that much popular, not being used a lot. Most of the times the survey based research are being preferred for this kind of study, right? Survey based research liya jata hai because it has higher scientific procedures, higher scientific value, higher trustworthy value in terms of methodology. And the procedures and techniques and steps used in survey based research are defined, fixed, formulas are structured, so you have a guidelines, proper guidelines how you can conduct a survey, and so that the survey based research designs are being adopted a lot. So when you are into survey based research design, when you are into descriptive research design, then you need to think of the population. right? Can anyone tell me what do you mean by population?
So all the people to whom we can approach, first we decide that. Then we segregate it as target, accessible, sample, and subject.
Okay, it means everyone who can be a part of your survey, every individual who can be a part of your survey. So yes. If I take a study, for example, if I take a study on understanding consumer perception towards COVID-19 vaccination or towards COVID-19 vaccine, right? Then who all are my respondents? Prima facie, all the people, those who are above 18 in India are my respondents, isn't it? Prima facie, all the people who all are above 18 years of age in India are my population. But you need to understand, is it possible for you to take a survey throughout the India in all the geographies? Can you study the behavior and perception of all the people above 18? So no, it is not possible. Then you have to understand, what is the target population? It means you have to segregate it down in some special characteristics of that population. For example, there is a difference between population. There is a difference between population parameters and target population parameters. Population is everyone. So maybe people living in rural and urban doesn't matter when you talk about the population. All the people, those who are from urban for rural. But is it like both of them have equal characters? Everybody can respond, but do both the groups of people have equal character? Absolutely not. Those who are living in urban are more literate. Those who are living in urban has higher purchase capacity, spending power, right? So, and those who are living in urban has higher access to the vaccine also. So there is a difference between the groups within the population. Aapke population ke within kuch groups hai. Right, and then you need to define to which group you are going to talk about. पहले तो सबके सामने क्या नजर में आएगा आपका? If you want to study the perception of individual towards COVID-19 vaccine, prima facie, all the people in India are your respondents. But you have to understand, in India also there are two major characteristics. एक तो rural population है, एक urban population, right? So then you have to talk about the kind of the one group that you are going to deal which talks about the target population. So among all population, you have to select the target population. So let's suppose you decided to talk about the perception of rural people toward COVID-19 vaccination, right? So what? Then you decided that you are going to talk to the rural people only. So what happened? Rural people has become your target population. Yes, no? समझ में आ रहा है मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ?
Yes, sir.
Right? So, deciding about the target population and then talking about the accessible population. Right? Accessible population. Accessible population. In the rural people, is it possible for you to go and talk to the all rural people of the India in all the states? Absolutely not possible. Then how you got the accessible population size? But it is possible for you to talk to the rural people in your own district. Right? You will select the district, or you may select your state for that matter. And from state, you can take the samples from all the districts, few samples from all the districts, and then you will be able to generalize the findings of that study to all India. Your aapke state mein, her districts mein se kuch sample leke, uska agar aap outcome nikalte ho, to that outcome can be applicable to entire India, right? So accessible population can be decided based on the geographical location of your population, right? Geographical access to the population. So you will decide about the accessible population, and then you will talk about the sample. Then among that, sampling. Now how to calculate sample? The sampling size methodology and sampling size calculation. Has it been taught to you in first semester? BRM mein padhaya hai sampling calculation?
Mathematically to nahi, lekin he told us that it should be more than 384 samples.
Yeah. Actually mathematically calculations अभी आपको पढ़ाने के लिए ना मुझे पूरा बीआरएम का दो चैप्टर रिपीट करना पड़ेगा, तो मैं भी मैथमेटिकली आपको नहीं पढ़ाऊंगा बिकॉज हाँ मैथमेटिकली पढ़ाने का मतलब क्या है, आई विल टेल यू हाउ द फॉर्मूला वर्क्स, आई विल टेल यू हाउ यू कैन पुट आउट द फिगर्स इनटू दैट, राइट? सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू नीड टू डिफाइन योर पॉपुलेशन, देन सिलेक्ट योर टारगेट पॉपुलेशन, देन टॉक अबाउट द एक्सेसिबल पॉपुलेशन. सो इफ यू रीच टू द एक्सेसिबल पॉपुलेशन देन वॉट इज द पॉपुलेशन ऑफ योर रिसर्च नाउ, आपकी रिसर्च पॉपुलेशन क्या होगी, जो एक्सेसिबल है वही आपका पॉपुलेशन होगा, राइट? जो एक्सेसिबल है वही आपका रिसर्च पॉपुलेशन होगा. And during that accessible population, you will select a sample. Now, the selection of sample depends on the total number of accessible population size. Population का total size कितना है? उसके ऊपर पता है, उसके ऊपर depend होता है कि आपका sample में कितने लोग आने चाहिए. But एक चीज याद रखो, हमेशा possible नहीं होता है कि total number निकालना. There are so many different kind of research studies in which you cannot identify the total number of rural population of your state. Kaise dhundoge? Very difficult, right? So in that case, what you do, then the sampling method comes into picture. Whether you are going to take the probability sampling or non-probability sampling, then cluster sampling, then strata sampling, those things comes into picture. Agar aapka population infinite hai, right? Infinite population hai, undefined hai, unrestricted hai, you cannot go for probability sampling. So non-probability sampling mein you will go conveniently, but to avoid the bias in the convenient sampling, you will take samples from all the geographies and you will divide your accessible population into clusters. So pure districts, pure state ko district mein divide karoge, and based on that you will find out how many people has to be contacted from all the district, and you will divide your population with the number of district to reach to the equal number of people from all the districts, right? You see, sampling and population and all those things are only there in order to reduce your bias, in order to reduce the bias in research. Agar aap apne district mein ghar ke baju mein hi 400 logon ka survey karoge to kya hoga, aapke ghar ke baju mein pata chale sabhi bahut ameer log rehte honge, but rural ka to fir garibon ka koi usme involvement hi nahi aayega. Another aspect, maybe the people with you, people living in your area would be a very educated. So uneducated ka koi input hi nahi aayega usme. So the population would not be unbiased population, and you cannot generalize the research reports or research findings of such groups to the larger population. So yahan pe kaisa hai, population ke baad target population nikala jisko aap access kar sakte ho, fir aapne accessible population nikala. एक्सेसिबल पॉपुलेशन में आपने क्या किया, पहले सैंपल साइज कैलकुलेट किया. तो सैंपल साइज कितना आता है, यू ऑल नो दैट फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ पॉपुलेशन 384 इज द सैंपल साइज जस्टिफाइड बाय क्रिसी एंड मॉर्गन, राइट? देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड मॉर्गन्स फॉर्मूला, मॉर्गन्स टेबल टू सिलेक्ट पॉपुलेशन. तो लेट सपोज तुम्हारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट में, एंड दिस ऑल्सो बिकम्स द इन्फिनाइट पॉपुलेशन. द एग्जाम्पल आई एम गिविंग टू यू ऑल इज ऑफ दिस COVID-19 वैक्सीनेशन. It's also a part of infinite population. So infinite population में आपको ये define नहीं कर सकते हो कि total population कितना है. Then what you do it is that you have, let's suppose, taken the number given by the census. Number given by the census of your state. आपका state का census होता है ना, rural में कितने लोग हैं, urban में कितने लोग हैं. You have taken that figure, estimated the sample size of 384. And 384 को आपने number of districts से divide किया, and then you went to the districts in a rural areas and taken the survey from that required sample, right? समझ में आ रहा है कैसे हो रहा है, क्या हो रहा है?
Yes, sir.
So that becomes your sample. Sample of 384 is a sample, and subject, research participants or informant. Actually, it is called as the respondent, right? It's called as the respondent, individual respondent. Individual respondent kaise identify kiya? Suppose 384 and aapke state mein, let's suppose kitne 20 hai districts, 20 districts to divide karo kitna aayega, kitna aayega 384 divided by 20 kitna hota hai, calculate karo. मतलब 20 respondents आपको हर स्टेट से लेना है. लेट्स सपोज 400 का साइज है, 20 डिस्ट्रिक्ट है, आपने हर डिस्ट्रिक्ट में जाते 20-20 लोगों से बात किया रूरल एरिया के, राइट, रूरल एरिया के 20-20 लोगों से बात किया, तो वो जो 20 लोग हैं, जो 400 लोग हैं, उसमें से एक जो इंडिविजुअल है वो होता है आपका सब्जेक्ट। तो आप एक इंडिविजुअल तक कैसे पहुंचते हो, दैट एंटायर प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रोसेस ऑफ सैम्पलिंग, राइट। अब इसके मेथड्स होते हैं, प्रोबेबिलिटी, नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी, टोटल पॉपुलेशन पता है तो प्रोबेबिलिटी लगाओ, नहीं पता है तो नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी लगाओ। नॉन प्रोबेबिलिटी में भी सैंपल पैरामीटर्स डिस्क्राइब करते हैं कि स्नोबॉल करना है, सैंपल पैरामीटर इन द सेंस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन। फिर से वही चीज होती है कि आइडेंटिकलिटी कितना है, हाउ मच योर पॉपुलेशन इज आइडेंटिकल। अगर एक मिनट रुको, मैं दरवाजा बंद करता हूँ। So the ultimate aim of doing sampling and all those things is, you know what, you as a researchers could not take a chance of creating a research bias. मैं एक example देता हूँ, आप समझ लोगे कि ये इतना niche classification करने का जरूरत क्यों है। For example, I wanted to study the I wanted to study about the smoking habits of MBA students, right? I wanted to study the smoking habits of MBA students, and I took the survey of 60 people from my class. I took the survey of 60 people from my class, whether you smoke, if yes, how much, if no, why not, and whatever the questions I wanted to ask, I have asked through the survey, right? समझ में आया मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ? मेरे क्लास के 60 लोगों का मैंने सर्वे किया. Or what I wanted to understand, I wanted to understand the smoking habits of MBA students, right? Let's suppose in Pune city, I wanted to study the smoking habits of MBA students in Pune city. मैंने मेरे क्लास के 60 लोगों को सर्वे किया, मैंने पूछा उसको, एक तो खड़ा करके पूछता हूँ या फिर मैंने आपको सर्वे करके क्वेश्चनर भर के ले लिया, and I have come up with the findings that 60% of people of my class smokes. Right, they are smokers. Is it applicable to all the population of Pune? Can I predict that? Can I say that 60% of the population of MBA students is a smoker population? Can I say that? नहीं बोल सकता हूँ मैं, right? क्यों नहीं बोल सकता हूँ? क्यों नहीं बोल सकता हूँ? वो भी लॉजिक है, बट अनदर पॉइंट इज दैट द रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ ऑल द काइंड्स ऑफ कैटेगरीज ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स इज नॉट देयर इन द सैंपल। मेरे सैंपल में क्या है, मैंने जो 60 लोगों को सैंपलिंग किया वो सब एक ही क्लास के हैं। आप एक ही इंस्टीट्यूट में हो, एक ही क्लास के हो, यू बिलोंग्स टू अ सिमिलर काइंड ऑफ सोशल स्टेटस। फॉर एग्जांपल, मैं सिम्बायसिस के स्टूडेंट से लिया, फिर अपने स्टूडेंट से लिया, और फिर किसी रूरल के एसपीपीयू के इंस्टीट्यूट से सर्वे लिया। फर्क पड़ेगा कि नहीं पड़ेगा, राइट? सो द क्लासेस ऑफ इंडिविजुअल्स, दोज हु कैन बी द पार्ट ऑफ द सर्वे, आर नॉट ट्रीटेड and not considered in that sample. So the outcomes of such studies cannot be generalized to the whole population. अगर मुझे यही करना था, अगर मुझे यही बताना था कि 60% पुणे के स्टूडेंट्स जो है एमबीए वाले वो स्मोकर्स हैं, ये मुझे प्रिडिक्ट करना था लार्जर लेवल पे, तो मुझे क्या करना चाहिए था? मुझे पूरे पुणे के कॉलेजेस से कुछ रिस्पॉन्सेस लेने चाहिए थे, 5-5, 10-10 जो भी मुझे चाहिए उतने, या फिर मुझे एटलीस्ट, if it is not possible for me to reach to all the class colleges of Pune, I could have reached to few colleges from all the four regions of Pune, that is east, west, north, south, right? East Pune, west Pune, north Pune, south Pune. Teen college ka survey le lo, 20-20 college ka students le lo, ya 40-40 le lo, and you will get the sample size. By doing such study, now can I say that the 60% of people in the Pune city, those who are doing MBA are smokers? Can I say that now? Is it sound, does it sound logical? राइट, तो वो मैं प्रेडिक्ट कर सकता हूँ. मतलब डोंट टेक इट लाइक एग्जाम्पल, इट्स जस्ट एन एग्जाम्पल. आई नो दैट 60% ऑफ अस डू नॉट स्मोक, राइट? वेरी फ्यू आर मे बी देयर, एंड दैट इज एवरीबडीज इंडिविजुअल चॉइस, सो वी हैव नो राइट टू से एनीथिंग ऑन दैट, वेदर स्मोकिंग इज राइट और रॉन्ग, और दैट इज नॉट द क्वेश्चन. सो आई जस्ट हैव टोल्ड यू बिकॉज दिस इज समथिंग, आई फील दिस इज समथिंग क्लोज टू यूर हार्ट, एवरीबडीज हार्ट, राइट? सो आई थॉट टू टेक दैट एग्जाम्पल. So this is the reason that you always need to think of the sampling method. You always need to think of population, target population, accessible population, your sample size, right? By studying only 60 people, I cannot come up with the finding that all the people, I cannot come up with the findings which can be generalized to the 6,000 people of Pune University MBA students, right? So I need to take an appropriate sample also, right? इंडिया के 20 लोगों को बात करके मैं पूरे इंडिया के लिए फाइंडिंग्स नहीं निकल सकता हूँ, राइट? सो द सैंपल इज आल्सो रिक्वायर्ड, दैट हायर नंबर ऑफ सैंपल आल्सो हेल्प्स यू टू रिड्यूस द बायस. इट इज ऑलवेज सेड इन द रिसर्च दैट मैक्सिमम इज द सैंपल साइज, एक्यूरेट आर द रिजल्ट. क्या मैक्सिमम इज द सैंपल साइज, एक्यूरेट आर द रिजल्ट, दैट इज वेरी नोन सेइंग इन द फील्ड ऑफ रिसर्च. तो इवन दो this man called Morgan and Tracy has suggested that you have to go with the sample of 384, right? You have to go with the sample of 384 for any kind of population. See, Tracy and Morgan, these both were the statisticians, those who were finding out what are the parameters you need to consider while you come up with the sampling size. So kya kya parameters lene chahiye the, ye jab wo study kar rahe the tab unko ye samajh mein aaya ki they have calculated this sample size based on various parameters. Mera aawaz chala jayega abhi.